Hi friends, my name's Hannah and I'm here to help you set up YNAB start to finish all on your phone. Let's go. All right, can't start making a YNAB budget without the app, so go ahead and download your free trial of YNAB. And hint, you don't have to start your YNAB budget on the first of the month. You don't even have to start it on a payday. You can literally start your YNAB budget on Friday the 13th, Tuesday the 23rd, any day, doesn't matter to us, just pick. Open up your handy dandy app and we're gonna create a new budget. We're gonna start by estimating our expenses. So create a category for each expense in your life. And if you scroll through the app, you can see that these categories have already been put into logical category groups, one for bills, one for goals, stuff like that. If a category applies to you, enter the amount you know you'll need for that expense. And while you're doing this, go ahead and tell YNAB when you need this money by and how often. For instance, is this a monthly expense or is it a weekly expense? Or maybe you need it by a specific date later on down the road. For expenses like my utility bills or my car payment, I'm going to make a monthly target set for the day that bill is due. And side note, for expenses that ebb and flow, like an electricity bill, go ahead and make your best ballpark guess, leaning toward the higher end, and you can always change this number over time as needed. For things like my every Monday night grocery trip, I can set a weekly target to have $100 every Monday. Or maybe we need to pay our Amazon Prime subscription a year from now, so I'm gonna set a target to save $139 by this time next year, and I can already see that I'm gonna need to set aside about $12 each month to be ready to pay that bill by the time it comes around. And while we're doing all this, don't forget to create categories for savings. You might want to save money for an emergency or a vacation or a future home purchase. YNAB has two target types geared towards saving. Using the savings balance target type is great when you know about how much money you're gonna want by a certain time, like me wanting to save $2,500 for a winter beach vacation for January of next year. And the monthly savings builder target type is an easy way to build sinking funds for expenses where we don't know when they'll happen or how much they'll cost, but we know we wanna be ready for them, like setting aside $50 every month for the vet fund or $100 every month for car repairs. And while you're adding all of your expenses and savings goals to your budget, don't forget to curate and customize. We want you to make your budget your own. That means adding categories that matter and taking away the ones that don't. Rearranging the budget in a way that makes sense to you and adding a little fun and pizzazz here and there because it's prettier to look at. Next, we're gonna add our bank accounts because we gotta fund our budget with the money we have. Two options here, you can link your bank accounts up to your budget or you can leave them unlinked. If you're linking your bank accounts, you're letting your bank send over any transactions that have been cleared at the bank and importing them into your YNAB budget. Or if you'd like to leave your accounts unlinked or live in a location that doesn't support linking accounts, tap unlinked and enter your current cleared balance at the bank for each account you add. Next, and the very best part, it's time to assign your dollars. This might be different than how you've budgeted before, but with YNAB, we only budget with the dollars we currently have at the bank. That means you don't add any future paychecks or any future inflows of money you think might be coming your way into your budget before they've been deposited into the bank, because that money's not yours yet. That would make your budget inaccurate and untrustworthy. So to get a little help divvying up the dollars we do have, use YNAB's auto assign tool. It'll consider how much money you have along with your due dates and other details and will help distribute your dollars based on your highest priority needs first. In my case, auto assign made sure all my utilities and bills were covered for the month, but it only covered a few weeks worth of groceries and gas. That's actually fine because I'm gonna get paid again in 2 weeks and I can finish fully funding those categories then. They're not nearly as important as making sure my bills with real due dates are fully funded. If you want to make any adjustments to this assignment, you can easily tweak and redistribute your dollars by tapping any category and shuffling those dollars around. But don't assign more money than you actually have. If the number at the top goes negative and red, this means you've assigned more money to your budget than you actually have in the bank. So you're gonna need to remove some dollars from this assignment until you hit $0 again. Once you're satisfied with how your dollars have been distributed, go ahead and assign them. And congrats, my friend, you officially have a budget. Now, as you spend and earn, record or import all your transactions into YNAB. Inflows go into the ready to assign category and all other spending and outflows get put in their appropriate category. And as time goes on, add new categories, adjust your targets, tweak the budget however you need to make all your financial dreams come true. To learn more, tap the help icon for more info or to chat with our award-winning support team, always ready to help. So, cheers to saving more, paying off debt, and totally owning your finances. Thanks for watching.